Are you a beginner or just have a hard time applying eyeshadows? Then this tutorial is for you. Today's beginner-friendly eyeshadow application tutorial is by far the easiest that you would have probably seen. I'm going to be showing you not one but three different common styles of eyeshadows, including foxy eye, smokey eye, and a cut crease that can be done in no time using the swipe and dab method. So sit back, relax, and enjoy, and let's start the show. The first step is to prime the lids, and for that I'm using the P. Louise base. You can also use a concealer if you like. And the brush that I'm using is just a dense concealer brush. I'm going to list a few of my favorites in the description box below. And the reason to prime your lids is because it's going to remove the discoloration that's there on your lid to give you a more even skin tone, and that is going to help the eyeshadow colors pop. To prevent this primer from creasing, I'm going to lightly set it with the Airspun Translucent Loose Powder. I'm going to be using the Morphe Jaclyn Hill Volume 2 palette today for all the looks. Let's start with what's trending, that's the foxy eye. I'm going to be using a piece of sticky tape. I'm going to stick it a couple times in the back of my hands just so I remove the extra stickiness. It's not too harsh on the skin that way. And I'm going to stick it as an extension of my lower lash line. This becomes my stencil for the outer corner. That way you don't have to worry too much about getting those super sharp straight edges. The tape is going to take care of that for you. I'm going to be obviously teaching you the easiest method, the swipe and dab method. And for that, I'm going to be using these sponge tip applicators that you get in any eyeshadow palette. And if you don't have this, not to worry, these are super affordable. I'm going to link them in the description box below. All I'm going to do is choose a deeper shade of brown. I'm going to dip the sponge tip applicator in the brown, and I'm going to swipe it in my outer corner one time. You can make the wing as big or as small as you like. And then right on top of it, I'm going to be using a metallic eyeshadow. Again, I'm dipping the sponge tip applicator in the eyeshadow, and I'm going to swipe it right above the brown eyeshadow that I just used. Now here I'm using a metallic eyeshadow, but you can use any color eyeshadow that you prefer, either matte or metallic. It's going to give you the same effect. And then I'm going to take my favorite dabbing brush. This is from Milani. And all I'm going to do is start dabbing over both the eyeshadows in the outer corner. Make sure to do it gently and make sure you're dabbing it on both the eyeshadows. What that's going to do is it's going to combine the eyeshadows and give you that beautiful ombre effect. So all you have to do is keep on dabbing till you're happy with the blend. Let's go ahead and remove the tape and reveal it. And as you can see, that wing has come out beautifully without much effort. I'm going to clean up underneath with some concealer. I'm using the Milani concealer in the shade 145. And then I'm taking more of the deep brown eyeshadow. With this nail brush, which also I'm linking down below in the description box, I'm going to extend my inner corner. And the trick here is to gently push the bridge of the nose with your finger so you can clearly see the inner corner to pull out that wing. We'll finish up with some mascara, but before that I'm curling my lashes with the Sally Hansen curler. And for mascara, I'm going to be using the Benefit Bad Girl Bang mascara, one of my favorites. And the way I'll be applying the mascara is by wiggling the wand and pushing the lashes outward and upward. I hope that was easy enough. Here's the first look, the foxy eye. Now let's create everybody's favorite, the smokey eye. I'm going to first dip the sponge applicator in this light brown shade, which is going to be my transition shade. And I'm going to swipe it in my outer corner just one time in the shape of a C. Next, I'm going to repeat the step with a deeper shade of brown, but I'm going to apply it within the larger C that we just created in the outer corner. So that way we can create that beautiful ombre from a deeper shade to lighter shade. And now I'm going to use my Milani dabbing brush and I'm going to dab over these two eyeshadows. And while I'm dabbing, I'm going to pull some of that color into the inner crease as well, whatever residue is left on the brush. And then I'm using the deeper brown shade by swiping it a couple times in my lower lash line to get that smoky effect. Using a lighter shade, I'm going to highlight my inner corners. And then I'm going to apply an antique gold shade on my lid with the sponge tip applicator first. And then I'm going to use my dabbing brush to dab over all the eyeshadows to get that smoky blended look. I'm going to finish up with some mascara. Again, I'm curling my lashes, and again for mascara I'm using the Bad Girl Bang from Benefit Cosmetics. And here is the completed smoky eye. Creating a cut crease can seem a little complicated, but not with this technique. We'll start with the transition shade with my sponge tip applicator. I'm going to define my crease. I'm going to repeat the same with the deeper shade of brown within the larger crease that we created, and I'm also going to swipe it in my lower lash line. Using the dabbing brush, I'm going to start dabbing at the crease so the two eyeshadows blend and give me that beautiful ombre effect. To deepen the outer corner, again, I'm using the dark brown shade, first with the sponge tip applicator, and then I'm going to blend it out with the dabbing brush. I'm taking some concealer with a nail brush and I'm just going to mark the area where I want to cut the crease. So that'll be my cut crease border, and right below that, I'm going to use a light metallic shade using the sponge tip applicator. To get a seamless blend, I'm diffusing the edge with my finger. I like to do an eyeliner with cut creases, so I'm going to be using the ColourPop liquid liner. This is the liquid liner pen to pull out a small wing as well as line my top lash line. And then using the Wet n Wild Breakproof eye pencil, I'm going to tight line. That's pretty much it, my friends. Now it's time to curl the lashes and apply the mascara and get done. And here is the completed cut crease. How easy were these three looks to create? And it gets done in no time with the swipe and dab technique. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please let me know in the comment section if you want to watch more beginner-friendly tutorials like these. And if you enjoyed this video, please don't forget to give me a thumbs up. And please consider subscribing if you're new here. I love you guys so much, and I will see you soon with a brand new one. Bye, guys.